So welcome to the bridge course from Pragati PU College. Today is day 9th and we are going to see the accountancy today. And what are the things we learned in the previous class? Do you remember what are the things we learned in the previous class? We learned about the
personal and impulse.
Good, excellent. So we learned about the meaning of accounting, then meaning of accounting transaction, then types of account, right? So all these three main things we learned in the previous class. Can someone tell what is accounting in simple terms? Nibita, Ashwini?
Record of our transactions.
Very good. Recording. Recording.
Recording of book of our.
Good. Simple language, you can say it is a recording of all the transaction what we do in a particular day or in a particular event. Right? And we'll see some more topics today. In this class, we are going to learn about the accounting cycles. What is that accounting cycle? First is the source document. Can someone tell who, what is a source document? It is an evidence. Right? It can be a bill, a receipt, invoice, cash, voucher. So everything is a source document. After that, we are going to enter each and everything as a proof. I said, right, in a book, we are going to write down everything. So that is called as a journal. Source document is an evidence from where we write all the data into a book. So that book is called as a journal. Into journal, from journal, we take all the data and we segregate the data. And we write again, once again, in a separate book. That is called as ledger. From ledger, we are going to make a trial balance sheet. From trial balance sheet, we are going to make a financial statement. So all these things we will learn. But remember this cycle. So this is called as accounting cycle. That means each and every step, step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, step 5, we are going to utilize all the data what we have collected from the evidence stage to financial stage. That means financial statement. Which financial statement which shows the company whether it is under profit. If it is profit, how much is the profit? Have you heard in the news and the newspaper, they would have mentioned that Wipro or Infosys has made a 30% profit this year compared to last year. You would have heard, right, in the news and all. So everything will come from financial statements. So from starting from source document till financial statement, you should learn everything. So that it becomes very, very easy for you. Then what is the meaning of? So accounting cycles, we know. We have seen the source document. We know that. And second thing will be is journal. So we need to understand how to make a journal. And what is the meaning of a journal? After journal, what comes? Ledger. Okay, ledger comes. So it will be always in the form of a T account. It is called as T account. Ledger is called as a T account. So everything, all these three things we will learn today and we will get into the details and depth. So accounting cycles. So as I explained to you, first is the source document. Right? First is the source document. Source document examples.
Invoice.
Very good. Invoice.
The receipt. Invoice.
The bill,
if you voucher,
good, excellent. So if you go to a shop in the food world and you buy a cake, what do you give? You give the money to them and they give the cake to you, and along with the cake, what they give? They give the bill, right? The bill, or it is also called as the receipt. It is also called as invoice. Next time, whenever you go to the food world or any of the shops, you ask for a bill, okay? And you just see, some would have used as cash voucher, cash debit, or some might have used as invoice. Okay, so there will be different names, but everything is same. Next time onwards, you should observe, because since you are getting into commerce stream, you people should as observe all the bills or all the paper, whatever it is coming to your hand. So that is the source document. Then after that, the journal is prepared. From the journal, a ledger is prepared. Ledger is also called as T account because it is in the form of T shape, that we'll see later. So it will always T account is called as ledger. So remember, after that, balance sheet. It is also called as trial balance. The term what the accounting people have given is called as trial balance. Next is final thing, that is the financial statements, balance sheet, then profit and loss account. So although whether profit, company is under profit or under loss, how much is the profit, how much is the loss, how much is the assets, everything will be given by the financial statement. If you, that is a single piece of paper, if you see that, you will come to know what is the health of the company, whether the company is doing a good health or a bad health. Health in the sense, in terms of money, whether the company is making good money or bad money. So everything will be known by financial statements. Let us see the definition. The accounting cycle is a collective process of, collective means total, collective process of identifying, analyzing and recording the accounting events of a company. That is called nothing but same thing, right? Accounting cycle means it is nothing but accounting only. Saturday we saw the definition of accounting, right? Same thing. It is nothing but a collective process of identifying. First of all, we need to identify an event. Event means buying and selling. Buying and selling. So many buyings and sellings will happen in a company, right? So because it is a huge company. So first we need to identify. Then we need to analyze how much money I spent today. On how much, what are the things I bought today? How much is spent? How much product is there with me? So everything has to be analyzed. And recording the accounting. Where do you record first? It should be recorded in a journal. That's what it is showing as recording. Okay. After that, it will be recorded in ledger. After that, trial balance. After that, financial statement. So these five things are very, very important. Okay. Now you know what is accounting cycle or accounting. Accounting cycle is a collective process of identifying, analyzing and recording the accounting events of a company. The series of steps begin when a transaction occurs and end with its inclusion in the financial statement. The meaning is there will be so many steps need to be followed. Okay, no, so many steps should be followed in making an accounting statement. Finally, everything should be included in financial statement. That is the meaning of it. Okay, the accounting cycle is identifying, analyzing and recording all the data, okay, of accounts, and everything should be included in the final financial statements. That is accounting cycle. So now you remember, right? Without seeing also you should be able to tell. First is source, second is journal, third is ledger, trial balance, financial statement. Why it is called as a cycle, accounting cycle? Because again, from financial statement, you can just segregate all the data and again, you can identify the source document from it. So that's why it is a cycle. That means, cycle means it should be closed. It is a closed cycle. Once you take the data from the source, finally, you should put all the data everywhere and the financial statement has to be released. That means the cycle is complete. That's why it is in the form of a circle. Circle means cycle. So always remember the accounting cycle. Now, what is this? This is a journal. So we know now the source document. Source document is a bill. Who will give the bill to you? A shopkeeper will give the bill to you. So you need not prepare anything. The shop person is going to prepare the bill or he is going to take a printout. But finally, the bill comes from the shopkeeper or the trader. So you need not do anything in it. Okay. Once you bring that bill into the company, then you have to give to the accountant. Then accountant will make a journal. Okay. The meaning of journal. You should remember the spelling of journal. J-O-U-R-N-A-L. Journal. Okay. So what does it say? It says, journal entry is a method used to record all individual financial transactions made by a company into its journal. That means very, very simple. See, it is used to record all individual financial transactions. It may be very small. Even for 50 paisa or 1 rupee, you would have bought some screws and nuts. That 1 rupee also you should get the bill. And if you are making some crores of rupees deal, between company A and company B. For that also, you'll get a bill, whether it is 1 rupee or 1 crore or 1,000 crores or 2,50,000 crores. For everything, there will be a bill. So all those things, whether it is small event or a big event, everything should be recorded in a book. That book name is called as journal. That's what the definition says. A journal entry is a method used to record all individual financial transactions. Individual means or even a small things. Small things, financial transactions made by a company into its journal. Journal is nothing but a book. Okay, it is a very big book where all the transactions what you made. For example, Ashwini will go to a shop today morning. Okay, after this class, she will go to a shop and she will buy some 5 kgs of rice from the shop and she will get one bill. After that, again, she will come back to home with the bill and the rice after paying the money. And again, her mother asks us to bring some chilies. So again, she has to go at 12 o'clock to some other shop and go get the bill. And again, at 4 o'clock, her mother will ask her to go and get the some tea powder. Again, she'll go pay some 200 rupees and get the tea powder along with the bill. So how many bills she has today? Today, she has got 3 bills with her. 3 bills or 3 receipts with her, right? And all those 3, it should be entered into a journal. Okay? A journal means it is nothing but a book. So all those things has to be entered into a book. The book name is called as journal. Very, very simple. To put it more simply, you can see here, it is the daily accounting input written in the journal for each business event. That means daily. Once she went in the morning, right, after this class, she bought some rice, 5 kg rice. Immediately, she has to give to an accountant and accountant is going to write 5 kgs from Ashwini's account. Okay. And how much rupees? Maybe 1,000 rupees. So everything has to be entered. Day wise, you can see here the format of journal is given here. Date is given here, 15th October 9, 2019. Then the heading will be given as journal. And the particulars of business transaction. Particulars means what is a business event? What is a business event happened today? That means furniture. That means furniture account. If you have bought the furniture is what? Is it a current asset or current asset or movable asset? It is an asset. Okay. So it is a movable asset where furniture. So that's why furniture account. AC means account. A/C. In accounting terms or in the business terms, we don't use the full form for the account. So we write it as A/C. A/C. Okay, furniture. We have bought furniture for how much amount? For $1,000. USD means US dollars. Okay, that means it is debited. And for which account it has to be debited? That means to bank account. Okay, to bank account. That means in credit side, it should come as $1,000. Both are same. Finally, what does it say? That means someone has bought the furniture to the company worth of $1,000 and the amount is taken from where? From the company's bank account. Simple. Okay. And I'll show you when it should come on debit side, when it should come on credit side. Now, as of now, you just understand like this. By seeing this journal, what you'll understand? You understand that some furniture, that is the asset, has been purchased by someone to the company or for the business. When it was purchased? It was purchased on 15th October 2019. How much was the worth of the furniture? It was worth of $1,000. That to US dollars. That is the whole meaning. That means see how beautiful everything is written clearly. So that is the power of journal. Even a small transaction, what you do, everything should be entered into a journal. Now you understood what is a journal? It is a record of all financial transactions made in a particular day. Okay, which is entered in a book. That book name is called as journal. What is journal? Journal entry, that means it is the recording of all financial transaction. That's it. And recording of all financial transaction in a book, that is called as journal. It might be small one or big one, but all the transaction has to be recorded into a journal. Clear? So that is the meaning of journal. See, general entries are the first step in accounting cycle. Which is the first step in the accounting cycle? In the accounting cycle, but first, what is required for general entries? Evidence is required, right? Once the evidence is there, then only you can get into the journal. So in accounting cycle, which is the first step, because we are going to enter all the transaction. So that's why it becomes the first step. So journal entries are the first step in accounting cycle. It is used to record all business transactions. See here, process. How the process goes? First, identify the transaction. How do you identify the transaction? As I said, Ashwini is going to a shop today, right? Three times she went to the shop and she bought different items. Morning she bought what? Rice. Afternoon, 12 o'clock she bought some. Chilies. And 2 o'clock she bought some tea powders. Correct. So we need to identify the transaction. This is a transaction. How many transactions has happened? Three transactions has happened today. First transaction is rice. Second transaction is chilies. Third transaction is tea powder. So that that identifying the transaction. That is the first process. That means how many transactions has happened. First, identify the transaction. Second one is analyze the transaction. What is the meaning of analysis? That means morning she bought rice. How much rice she bought? 5 kgs. How much is the cost for that? Maybe 1,000 rupees. And what? When did he bought? When did she bought? She bought today. So today is 26th May. That has to be entered. Okay. And second, chilies. How much for 10 rupees? When did she bring? Today, 26th May. Then third one, tea powder. Tea powder was 200 rupees. Okay. And when did she bring? She bring it on 26th May. So all these things has to be analyzed and everything should be making journal entries. That final thing will come. Everything has to be written in a journal, in a book. Okay. Journals only will come in a separate book. If you go to the market and you should ask for a journal. So journal means it is a very big book. Everything will be printed. See, all these things, the date, particulars, folio. Folio means the receipt number, then debit or credit. All these things will be already printed. Just you need to start entering it. You need not use the scale and pencil and draw it. Okay. But in first PU and second PUC or in degree, you're going to use scale and a pencil to make the table on your own so that it becomes practice for you. Once you get into the professional things, you'll get the ready-made books where already everything will be printed. Just you need to enter the data. That's it. Understood? So hope you understood what is the meaning of journal. So now let us see. What is the next thing which come? From the journal, we are going to take the data and make a ledger. This is the second book. So let us see what is the meaning of a ledger. What is a ledger? A ledger entry is a record made of a business transaction. Okay, ledger entry is a record made of a business transaction. Same like journal. Journal, simply you can write something nonsense inside the journal book? No. What is the thing that you are going to write in the journal book? All business transaction, the record of business transaction. Ledger is also a record of business transaction. The entry may be made under either the single entry or double entry bookkeeping system. Double entry, do you remember the double entry system? Anyone? Different types of accounting we have seen, right, last week? The double entry system gives rise to what? Which gives rise to the formula Anna's loose coat. Now you remember, asset is equal to liabilities plus capital. That means buying and selling both should be there. Then only we call it as double entry system. See, what are the learn slowly you can? Slowly everything will be given in the next chapters. So that we should be very, very alert and careful so that we can revise all the, we should revise all the previous classes so that it becomes easy for you. Now, once again, we'll see the entry may be made under either single entry or double entry bookkeeping system, but is usually made using the double entry format only, where the debit and credit sides of the each entry is always balanced. very, very simple. Already we saw that accounting equation formulas and we did lot of problems, right? So where accounting equation, what does accounting equation say? Formula, Anna's loss quote. That means asset is equal to liabilities plus capital. That means left hand side should always be equal to right hand side. See here, simple. So this is how is the ledger account. Ledger means what you should remember. I said you should remember a T. Is T mentioned here? Are you able to see the T here? The line, horizontal line, vertical line. So this is a ledger. Okay. So left side, if you come, left side is always a debit side. Right side is always a credit side. Remember. So ledger account means you should remember the T. It is called as a T account. If some people refer to T account, don't get confused. T account means it is a ledger account. Clear? So what is a ledger account? It is a T account where left hand side should always be equal to right hand side. Okay. Left hand side should be equal to right hand side. That means first left hand side means debit, right hand side means credit. What are the things which will come in debit side? Expenses, assets, and drawings. What is a drawing? We saw the drawing, right? Withdrawal, drawing the money, drawing money from the capital amount, drawing the money from ATM. So all those, drawing means withdrawing. If 100 rupees is there with Ashwini, I'll ask Ashwini to give me 10 rupees. So I am drawing 10 rupees from Ashwini. Prashant sir is drawing 10 rupees from Ashwini. How much money is left with Ashwini now? 90 rupees. Okay. How much is the drawings? Drawings is 10 rupees. So that is the meaning of drawings. Excellent. So debit examples, expenses, assets, drawings. So you should remember in a ledger, if any expenses is there, so everything should come on debit side only. If any asset is there, I'm going to buy furniture. I'm going to buy land, building, everything, machineries. So everything should come on left side only. And I'm going to spend 20 rupees on a biscuit. Where it should come, right side or left side? It should come on left side. Why? Expense is there in the left side. Okay. And drawings. So always remember in the short form, D, E, A, D. What does it become? It becomes dead. See, that's why D, E, A, D. This is very easy form to remember, shortcut. So ledger account means first you should remember it is a T. And left hand side should be equal to right hand side. So left hand side will always, left hand side is dead. Always, okay. What is dead? Debit, expense, assets, drawings. So remember as dead, D, E, A, D, dead. Right side, how we should remember? You should remember as click. CLIC is click. That means credit, liability, income, capital. Clear? Credit, liability, income, capital. So always right hand should come as click, CLIC click. Remember children, what is the meaning? What is a ledger? Ledger is a record of business transaction. It is a record of business transaction similar to journal. Okay, if they ask for, they will ask for 3 or 4 marks, okay, in first PU. What is a ledger? Ledger is a record of business transaction. Simple, okay? It is a record of business transaction. And it is in the form of a T. So it is also called as a T account. So left hand side is dead, right hand side is click. So always remember, you should never forget this shortcut in your life, okay? Ledger account means T shape, left hand side is dead, right side is click. Hope everyone understood, children. See, let us get into the details of this one. So, T account. What is T account? What is T account? T account is nothing but what? Ledger. Correct? It is nothing but ledger. Mm-hmm. So, what is a ledger account? T account is a visual presentation of different journal entries that are recorded by the company in its general ledger account, in such a way that it resembles to the shape of alphabet T and depicts graphically credit balances on right side of the account and the debit balances on the left side of the account. Don't worry about this complicated English. You can write on your own. What is a T account? Means T account is a record of transaction in a visual format. See, it is visually, it is in the form of T. See here, horizontal line, vertical line. So this is the format. Okay, for format, they will ask 2 marks. Write the format of T account or the ledger account. Yeah, how it should come? It should come like this only. Account number, then horizontal line, vertical line. That means T you should write, left side is always dead. That means it will start with debit. Right hand side is always click. It will start with credit. So this format, if you write, you will get 2 marks.
Credit.
Yeah. Scoring, it is very, very high scoring subject, accountancy. Only thing, you need to just concentrate and practice daily. Okay, it should be fun. It should not be pain. Okay, you should take it as a pleasure and you should do it so that you will get very good marks. I think some disturbance is there at background. Okay, just give me a minute. I'll take the photo of the attendance. Yeah, I've taken. Trisha, I think she's the new girl. Trisha, you're from which school, ma? Trisha?
Pragati only, sir. Pragati.
Pragati, okay. And Vaishnavi? I'm seeing someone by name Vaishnavi. Madan KN. I request all the students to put the school name in the bracket, please. Okay, it becomes very easy for me to take the attendance. Done? Okay. Last 10 minutes is left. We will see this. So, what is a T account? T account is an what account?
Ledger account.
It is a ledger account. Very good. T account is a ledger account, and it is for, it is always in the form of a T, where left side is debit, right side is credit.
Credit.
Okay, this is the T account format. And let us see this small video. Okay, and please put all on mute. I am seeing some disturbance. Okay, we will. So I think it gave a lot of information, right? We'll see, watch one more time. There are so many different steps they have shown, right? Starting from journal and trial balance, financial statements and all. Just once again, watch this video carefully and see what are the steps, okay? Thank you. So did you get it right? If you see this, see there are so many different types of cycles. Okay, there are different types of events in a accounting cycle. So we learned about 5 cycles. That is enough for our first PU level. But if you get into the real thing, see, analyze the business transaction. First we need to analyze, then journalize, then put all the business events into a journal. That is called as journalized transaction. Next, post to ledger accounts. Okay, then after that, that means ledger is prepared here, the T account is prepared here, then the trial balance is prepared. Again, journalize and post adjusting requirement entries. If anything is wrong, left hand side is not matching to right hand side, again you need to adjust it. Again the trial balance has to be adjusted here, because already trial balance is completed here. You'll understand what is trial balance in further classes. Okay, and again that has to be adjusted. Then financial statement has to be prepared. Then journalize and post closing entries. That means if any, again, something is missing or something has to be added. See, here in accountancy, there are a lot of assumptions. And assumptions, you cannot just like assume and put something value. Okay. As we saw in last year week's class. So accountancy, the definition and why accountancy is required, because for the uniformity and for the, and the assumption also should be taken from the book. There is some book prepared, published by the agencies. Okay, some groups. So where all the, throughout the world, everyone will follow the same thing. From that, we need to see and do the adjustments. So that's why you need experience in doing the financial statement. So finally, the financial statement will come into picture. So in accounting, there is a lot of assumptions, lot of things we need to consider. Everything has to be adjusted. So that's why you can see here, prepare a trial balance. And if you see here, prepare an adjusted trial balance. Okay, again here, journalize and post-closing entries. So everywhere here, those things are repeating. Why it is repeating means, if something is missing, something is not getting adjusted. See, remember one thing. In accountancy, what are the problems you are going to do, or what are, whether it might be ledger, it might be journal, it might be trial balance, it might be financial statement. Always the left-hand side amount should be equal to the right-hand side. Left-hand side amount, total amount, should be equal to the right-hand side total amount. So remember that, okay? And if something is missing, then you need to assume what is missing. Then how to consider it? We need to refer the Bible. So Bible in the sense, the accounting Bible will be there, where the things will be prepared by the global people, and where all the countries use that Bible kind of thing. So we need to refer that and put that assumption here, so that left hand side will be equal to right hand side. So many things, all those things we'll learn slowly. Okay, so what are the things we learned today? So another 3 minutes is left. So before that, we'll just see what are the things we learned today. So we learned about the accounting cycles. For our first PU level, how many steps are required? 5 steps are required. That's it. One is source document. Second is journal. Third one is T account, or also it is called as a ledger account. Fourth will be the trial balance and the financial statement. Accounting cycles we learned. What is accounting cycle? Accounting cycle is nothing but recording of the business transaction. Recording of the business transaction into a book of accounts. The book of accounts may be journal or it might be ledger. Okay, so don't worry about that. So accounting cycles we learned today, and the meaning of journal we learned. So what is a journal? Journal is a book of entry or a book of transactions, where all the business transactions are entered day wise and event wise. What is an event? Buying a furniture is an event. Okay, buying a furniture is an event. So you can see the furniture is bought for how much rupees? $1,000. From which account it is taken? From the bank account it has been taken. Which bank? Company's bank. So $1,000 has been removed and it has been given to the furniture fellow, and we have bought the furniture for $1,000 for the business on 15th October. See, so much details are getting. So that is the journal. That means recording all the business transaction into a book. That is called as journal. And what is the meaning of ledger? Ledger, you know, you should never forget that it is in the T format. Okay, left hand side is dead, right hand side is click. So left hand side is debit side, right hand side is credit side. So all these things, see, here DR is given, right, in journal. We will see in detail about the journal tomorrow this class. Okay, so you will understand why DR should be written, why CR should be written here in the journal, and why this debit side, it is called as debit side, why it is called as credit side. So everything we will see in the tomorrow's class. I think we are going to, just 1 minute is left and I'm going to exit from the class today. Okay, thank you so much for being with me today, and tomorrow we are going to see in detail about the journal. Okay, children, thank you so much for being with me. Thank you so much. Bye.